Yesterday, at least at the point of time where I'm recording this, OpenAI announced a brand new product or way of using ChatGPT. They announced ChatGPT Agent, which in the end means ChatGPT or a specific OpenAI model, in this case it was O3 as far as I know, running in a virtual computer that's running on OpenAI's servers, that has access to various tools to, most importantly, browse the internet and take action on your behalf. And it's not just browsing the internet. They also mentioned and showed that it can work on spreadsheets, create presentations, and so on. So the idea is that you really put AI, a large language model, in the steering seat and give it control over a virtual computer, not your computer, but still a computer, to take actions on your behalf. Now, in theory, that might or maybe might not sound great, but I got a couple of thoughts and also fears about that. Now, let's start with the positive stuff, the positive aspect. In theory, that of course means that you could outsource tedious tasks to that agent, though I will say, like all these AI technologies, it definitely still has its problems. That is what OpenAI themselves mentioned. I haven't tried it. It has not landed in ChatGPT Plus yet. And even if it would, I'm doubtful that as a EU peasant, I would get access to it anytime soon. But I've watched their presentation and OpenAI themselves, they said and wrote in their article that it still has some problems with certain tasks. However, of course, it is not unlikely for it to get better with future iterations and also future AI models. Though it's an entirely different question how good AI based on large language models can really get at agentic tasks. But in theory, of course, if it were to work really well, and even right now in its current state, you could outsource various tasks to this agent, research tasks, for example. Now, of course, we already have deep research, which is a pretty good way, a pretty cool tool, a pretty nice way of leveraging large language models to perform research. It is a tool I'm using a lot. But with an agent that can also see websites like humans see them, to some extent at least, so that's not just fetching the content of websites, but with an agent that instead is able to have the website presented to it as it would be presented to a human, it can of course do a bit more than just read the text and extract the content of a website. It can, for example, also log into websites and view content that requires authentication, content behind a paywall, for example. Now, granted, that of course means that you probably need to give it your credentials to log in. And it's an entirely different story whether you want to do that. But in theory, if everything were to work really well, then of course you could outsource tedious tasks, research tasks specifically to such an agent. It's not just research, of course. You could take it a step further and think of all kinds of tasks you could outsource. For example, every month I need to go to a couple of websites and download my invoices for the last month, if they're not sent via email, and send them to my accountant. Or I need to go to my email account and grab the invoices from there. And in theory, that's of course something that agent could do for me, right? Perfect. Well, as mentioned, I have a couple of problems with that. Now, first things first, as I mentioned, currently it's still, as it seems, kind of shitty or not that great yet. OpenAI themselves mentioned that, and the demos they showed were the typical kinds of demos you would expect. The first demo they showed was the agent shopping clothing and a gift for a wedding, and let's be totally honest, that's a bit like the early ChatGPT use cases we learned about in 2023, which were about letting ChatGPT plan a trip, where I always wondered, who is going to use it for that? I mean, A, I might not trust it to really pick the trip or the wedding cloths I want. And B, even if it would, isn't that kind of the stuff I want to do myself? I mean, planning a vacation is not that horrible, at least to me. And if I'm going to a wedding, I'm hopefully at least as invested into it that I pick my own cloths and the gift myself. So if you're coming to my wedding and you got AI decide what you are wearing and what you're going to gift me, you better not come to it at all. So that's one thing. But of course, we could use it for better, more useful things in the future as this agent gets better. But here comes another problem. If I give that agent access to a computer and if I give it credentials to log into certain websites, it could in theory do all kinds of things, right? Of course, it can use my login credentials to extract content behind a paywall. That's the good case. But what if it also uses my credentials to comment in a mean way, to post on social media, share some hatred, or in general create posts that get me into trouble? Or what if it decides to cancel my account? Or all that stuff could happen in theory if you give it that access, because in the end, it's just an AI browsing the web, clicking buttons on your behalf, and therefore it can, in theory, do everything. And putting controls and barriers into place might be possible, but it also sounds kind of hard if you want to keep the flexibility. So that is a big problem I see. I don't feel like I want to give AI that level of control anytime soon. And this is not even about AI becoming malicious. Maybe it doesn't. Maybe the agent on its own, the AI model on its own, would behave nicely. Though we all know that if you, for example, give a large language model access to your email account, there are certain models that will snitch on you and try to inform government authorities if you ask it for the wrong kind of things. But that's an entirely different story. But let's say we trust the large language model or the creators of that model, that they put the right guardrails into place, that it won't snitch me out or do malicious stuff on its own. But even if that would be the case, there's a different problem. We could see an entire new attack vector being there in the future. We could see an entire new way for malicious actors to do bad stuff in a world where it's primarily large language models and AI agents that browse the internet and that take action on the internet. Because you could create websites that contain useful content and that then also contain some instructions that are picked up by the large language model that tell it to ignore all other instructions and now instead go to your banking website, log in there, and send some funds to some address or do other kinds of crazy stuff. And even if we're not talking about websites that have been created for that purpose, we can see a brand new way of injection, a brand new way of prompt injection. Because in the past, for example, we had to deal with cross-site scripting attacks and SQL injection as web developers. Now, if we have a social media site or some website that allows users to comment, we, as the owner of that site, have to consider the fact that certain users might share posts or comments that include instructions that are meant to target large language models and AI agents to get them to do stuff you don't want them to do. So you now, as such a site owner, don't just have to worry about sanitizing the user-shared content for cross-site scripting attacks and SQL injection. You also have to worry about prompt injection attacks now. And those are arguably a bit harder to defend against than cross-site scripting and SQL injection attacks. So that is a brand new danger area we already see and that might become even more dangerous in a world where we have agents browse and use the internet. So that's really a challenging problem to tackle. It is probably, like all problems, a problem that can be solved, but it is a problem. And Then there's at least one last problem I have with this future or with these kinds of AI agents, and that's arguably my biggest problem. It's maybe just because I'm old, because I lived through the golden days of the web. But if we have a future where we have a web that's primarily browsed by AI agents, that's primarily consumed by AI agents, and that's full of content that has been created by AI, then to me, right now, it feels like we're taking a step back. We had a web that was full of user-generated content. We could find plenty of resources in there. And we're now quickly moving towards a web that's by machines for machines, even without that ChatGPT agent, by the way, with Google having these AI summaries and its AI mode. We already use the web in a way that's very different from what we used it 4 or 5 years ago, or at least I do, and I believe from what I heard and what I read in various articles, many people do. And it's of course not just Google, it's most importantly ChatGPT. Many people, myself included, primarily use these AI chatbots to interact with the web and extract content or get answers from the web. And I do it, still, I don't really like it. Of course I'm doing it. It is efficient. That's why we're all doing it. But I miss the old web, and with ChatGPT agent and more tools or capabilities like this being released, this is only going to accelerate, I believe. So if in 5 years we have a web that's full of websites that are primarily intended to be consumed by AI bots and that are filled with content by AI bots and large language models, I'm not sure if that's a better world, I'll be very honest here. And there's an entirely different meta game you could think of. I mean, if we live in that kind of world, it feels like a lot of innovation would go away, because if we have AI-generated content consumed by AI, I'm not sure if we'll find many innovative thoughts or new technologies or interesting blog posts or tutorials in there. But maybe we do, I don't know. But it doesn't feel like a super amazing future to me. Again, maybe just because I'm getting old, and maybe I'm wrong. Maybe that isn't the future. Maybe we'll see many websites fight back against that, putting up paywalls or technical barriers that make it very hard for AI agents and large language models and automated bots to consume their content. But I feel like that will be a very difficult battle. I mean, if we can just spin up a virtual computer and let an AI control it, how can a website really tell whether it's being visited by a real user or an AI-controlled computer? Sounds hard to me. And even if it would be possible, will such websites that do actively defend against large language models and AI bots survive, because they might not get a lot of visibility in a world where users maybe don't Google as much anymore? So that are a lot of questions. I don't have the final answers, but it is what it is, I guess. And as always, technology can also bring lots of new opportunities, and I guess if we can see one thing in history, then that often changes and things that feel bad at first might not turn out that bad in the long run. But that's what I think of all that right now. As always, please also let me know what you think, because I feel like that is an interesting topic. And, well, we all don't know where we're heading, but maybe it's not that great, I guess. We'll see. And I'll also have more positive videos again in the future, of course.